Just wanted to bring up my Bible tonight.
Because
I thought we'd end with a little something from the Lord.
Yeah.
My Lord and Savior. And, she's rested. She's all lying down. That's good. It's good.
It looks like a grandma Bible.
Yes. But I did it on purpose. I'm going for that grandma Bible look. Because,
the Malibu Barbie Bible was too much.
I just want you to know that sometimes I talk about things from the Bible and people don't believe me that it's really in there. So I brought it up tonight so you could see the truth. Here we go. This is something called Ezekiel 23, which I tried to read last week because I didn't have a Bible with me. No one believed it was really in there. So here we go. This is about two adulterous sisters. What I'd like you to do is think about how you could write this in a TV show or something.
Okay.
Because we need to get some good scripture stories here. Because the mistake they make on the religious channel is they'll do stories from the Bible, but they always leave out the good stuff. And what I mean by the good stuff is, you know, the real stuff. That if it was in there, people wouldn't have to go to porn sites. You guys, you could save so much money! Do you know, you can look at the Bible on the internet for free. You don't even have to pay a monthly fee.
Why are you looking at me?
Because whenever porn comes up, you seem to know something about it. Anywho, all right. Not that I will judge. I shall not judge. Because I have looked before at porn. And what I realize over and over again, because I just want to make sure I'm getting it right. Like, no way. Is this really like this? I haven't looked in a while, though. Don't feel bad, Jarens. Now you're a little religious. You have an image of me being so perfect and holy. I want to keep it. All right. Because one day I want to be married like Eliana. You know, and I know I have to be all pure and pristine.
That's not true.
I know. I know. It's the opposite, actually. And what I find when I go to porn sites is that it's really anti-women.
Yes.
And then I realize I can't get excited by it at all. And then I realize, oh, I'm a feminist, duh. And I also realize, oh, this isn't really for guys that know how to have healthy relationships with women. It's for lone masturbators
right. That
have been dumped because they're not good in bed.
Whoa.
Right? Hey. And I'm just saying,
just take
like,
on the chin, Jared. Just take on the chin.
Oh, it's just. It's really harsh and really, and like they have their choice between sticking it in a woman's vaginal cavity, or in her rectum, and they'll choose the rectum. There's like a warm, wet hole right there where there's a clit attached where she might enjoy it, and instead they go for the thing with no clit because they're secretly gay and they want it in their butt. And they're like, I can't do that because that makes me gay, so let me stick it in hers. It's wrong. The other thing is there's no clit in a woman's mouth or in the back of her throat, as opposed to popular belief. And it's just awful. Like, there was one where there were a bunch of guys, and they weren't even sticking their penis in her. They were sticking like a boat oar. It's really wrong. It's really wrong. And then just so they wouldn't get sued, they had the girl afterwards go, I loved it. And I could tell she was on meth because there's no way. Yeah. Because no human being, I mean, likes to have that done to them, you know, unless they're on meth and they're not feeling their body anymore. So something violent feels like something good, and so I'm just here to say that I do not think porn is for me. It is not my kind of thing, is all I'm saying. But this is the kind of book I think we should be reading, which is the Bible, Ezekiel 23. Here we go. The word of the Lord. You jest now, you laugh now. You watch it. Here we go. Because isn't it supposed to be like end of the world pretty soon?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Bible actually says anybody who tells you that is a liar. Face. They're the Antichrist. They don't believe it. Just, you know. We're supposed to be good anyway. We're not supposed to be all bad. And then, oh, time's up. Woohoo! Let's put on some normal clothes and act all repressed. Maybe we'll get chosen. Okay. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, there were two women, daughters of the same mother. They became prostitutes in Egypt, engaging in prostitution. In case you didn't know what that meant, being a prostitute. Sometimes the Bible's a little redundant, isn't it? You're like, get an editor. Anyway. So if you guys are writing a scene for this in a TV show that we're starting called Alexandra Karova's Bible, edit that part. Just say they're a prostitute. You don't have to tell us, by the way, doing prostitution. It's like saying, a car maker, who, by the way, was making cars. From their youth in that land, their breasts were fondled and their virgin bosom caressed. This is my kind of porn. This is way better than that weird violent stuff online that guys are into. Yeah, I love Jesus. Okay, here we go. And this is why. The Lord's the best at everything. Okay. The older was named Ohola, and her sister was Oholiba. They were mine and gave birth to sons and daughters. Ohola is Samaria, and Oholiba is Jerusalem. Right here, it's letting you know it's a metaphor. So anybody who says, Bible's supposed to be taken literally, word for word, they didn't even read it. Because right here it says, symbolically, this sister is Jerusalem, the other one is Samaria. Don't act like you don't know who I'm talking about. Samaria and Jerusalem. Anyway. Ohola engaged in prostitution while she was still mine, and she lusted after her lovers. Well, isn't that what you're supposed to do if they're your lovers? Aren't you supposed to? Isn't that sort of intrinsic in the whole definition of having a lover? Wouldn't it be awful to have a lover that you didn't lust after?
It is.
Yeah, that would be marriage. Sort of like spousal rape. Yeah, it's wrong. Okay. Anyway. She lusted after her lovers, Assyrians, warriors, clothed in blue, governors and commanders. Well, you know, if you are going to have a lover, he's got to be hot. So it does make sense that they would be a warrior, right? Like in our modern day, it would be like a really well-built guy who's got a job. Oh, I'm all judgmental now? Okay. Like, you don't want a good-looking woman with a job. Oh, whatever, okay. That's money coming in. That's a job. Okay. Another version, in case I got it wrong, was, for they were all attractive young men, captains and commanders, in handsome blue, dashing about on their horses. So they had cars, so they were hot to trot. And so she sinned with them, the choicest men of Assyria. Well, who are you gonna sin with? Not the ugly old fart heads? What? Like, you guys, you're gonna go for the better looking ones. Even when there's a cougar you go for, you go for the hot ones. You go for the ones in the yoga pants. I've heard your sets before. You don't want a girl your own age if she ain't pretty. That's what you said tonight. They gotta be hot. So what is this? Okay. What are you supposed to? Okay. She gave herself as a prostitute to all the elite of the Assyrians. Okay, so she was going out with the celebrities, right? The really well-connected ones. And defiled herself with all the idols of everyone she lusted after. It's always good to walk the crowd with the Ezekiel 23 porn take. I'm cutting it! Woo! Ah, praise the Lord! All right. Some people just can't handle the word of the Lord. Right, she did not. The Lord said this message is not for everyone. Only because you can handle it. The person obviously prefers real porn. It's supposed to the Holy Word of God.
Maybe they just don't like their Bible quite so
and
clearly.
I don't like porn. I like the Bible because I'm holy. She did not give.